animals were going to be brought back to life. Even animals also will come. So even the animals also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that they have a raja'a. They died and they came back to life and they lived for a certain period of time before they were dead. That is example number two. Example number three, in the Quran also, as the people of Cave as have returned, which we all read, the whole surah was about them. A youth who were young guys, they lived under a tyrant known as the Qiyanus, who wanted to force people to serve idols besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these young guys said, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ فَلِدْنَهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ. Young guys, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in return, we increase their guidance. That they realize that no matter what happens, we shouldn't stay in this land where we will be forced to serve someone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they left the town. What happened? Until they get to the cave where they say, let's take a nap and rest. Allahu Akbar. Quran tells them that after they get into that cave, they took a nap. For many of years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described their situation. They were sleeping. But when you look at their face, it's like they are awake. You know the secret? Allahu Akbar. The secret is so that nobody can steal their items. Because if they look that they're awake, and you come, you know, this guy awake, are you going to try to steal their stuff? They're not. No. But in real, they are not awake. They are asleep. And Allah said, وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. We send them left and right to keep the circulation of blood working. That's why you and I, when we're asleep, even though you're asleep, but you see sometimes you turn. Huh? Back, front. What? So that the circulation keeps on, so that you still keep yourself alive. So Allah said, we kept doing that. And amazing, Allah said, وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ. Sometimes in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, certain jobs, he tells us that I have given the angels to do it. فَالْمُدَبِّرَاتُ أَمْرًا قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتُ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you that there are certain angels that I have assigned to do the job, right? But when it comes to those mu'mineen, those fitya, Allah did not say, no, we assign angels to take care of them. Allah said, وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ. That we are the one doing the job. That we are turning them back and forth. Why? To tell you how these people have been honored by Allah being in their service. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِتٌ ذَرَاعَيْهِ بِالْوَسِيدِ لَوِ اتَّلَعْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ لَوَلَّيْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِرَارًا وَلَمُلِئْتَ مِنْهُمْ رُعْبًا. Quran says, when you see them, the appearance, the way they were laying down, the way they are sleeping, Quran says, you will be scared because they look like they're awake, but they are not sleeping. Their faces look like they are looking at you, but indeed they were asleep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, until they are brought back to life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the one of them says, إِبْعَثُوا بِوَرَقِكُمْ هَذِهِ إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ. They send one of them to go to the city to get them food. Allahu Akbar. After years and years of sleeping or death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them back to life. Allahu Akbar. This is one of the concepts of raja'a in the Quran. And now let me give you one ayah which can clarify the whole thing. In Surah Ghafir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and this is one of the reasons why we say there are two groups that Allah is going to bring back to life. One is the mu'mineen, one is the kuffar, the bad ones. Now listen to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا أَمَتَّنَا اثْنَتَيْن وَأَحْيَيْتَنَا اثنتين. Quran Surah Ghafir. Alhamdulillah. You Arabs, you understand. You look in Surah in Mufradat al-Raghib. When we say al-maut, ماذا تعني? انفصال الروح عن الجسد. Allah said in the Quran, أمتنا اثنتين, twice. وأحييتنا اثنتين, twice. Means we lived on this land for twice. and we died, or we also died twice. فَاعْتَرَفْنَا بِذُنُوبِهِ. This indicates that the second group that Allah is going to bring them, the bad people, these are the people who live on this planet and they did a lot of bad things. And they went to Allah, and what did they do? قَالُوا رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِي لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا. Oh Allah, return me, take me back to this world. I will do better. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that they are not going to do it. But they insist and insist. And Allah said, this is your last part, go. Now they come to this world and nothing changed. They were the same people, the same bad things. So now they get back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the second time. Now what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا أَمَتَّنَا اثْنَتَيْنِ وَأَحْيَيْتَنَا اثْنَتَيْنِ فَاعْتَرَفْنَا بِذُنُوبِنَا. Say now, we have confessed. اعتراف بِذُنُوبِنَا. فَهَلْ مِنْ خُرُوجٍ؟ فَسَبِيلٌ. Is there any way that we can get out of this? This is the concept of Raja in Islam. But what is the concept this Raja says? What is the benefit of Raja? Let me two things. Number one, the Raja says that, number one of the benefit of Raja is that to prove to those who think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot bring the dead people back to life, Allah wants to prove them that no. That Allah says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, بَلَا قَادِرِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَا لَا أُقْسِمُ بِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَّ النَّجْمَ عِظَامَةِ بَلَا قَادِرِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَا. For those who doubt that, how can that be possible? That after we die and we turn dust, how can Allah bring us back to life? Like in Surah Yasin, a man who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, you talking about the day of judgment. وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَثَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقَهُ قَالَ مَنْ يُحْيِي الْعِظَامُ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ. The man, when the Prophet was talking about the Al-Qiyamah, Al-Nushur, he went to the grave of his father and he brought some bones to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said to the Prophet, Ya Muhammad, you're talking about the day of judgment. You're talking about the Qiyamah. How can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring my dad back? And the force of his father that he had, he crushed them together and they became like a powder. Say, how can this come back to life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَثَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقًا. He forgot his own creation. قَالَ مَنْ يُحْيِي الْعِظَامَ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't respond. He said, كُلْ يُحْيِي.